Greetings. Brother Omar, I have listened to you recite the claims that Muhammad is mentioned in the Song of Solomon, verse 5:16. I understand the claim you are taught to make, brother, but there is a facet which you repeat that you have not thought about. You have told me that Eem is the plurality of respect for Muhammad, and the one and only example you can offer is the term Elohim. When you asked, "Don't you get that?" I could hear your frustration. Believe me, brother, I have heard, and I understand the claim and argument you are taught to make. Allow me to explain the error in the teaching that Eem is a plurality of respect. I don't expect you to just accept my answers. Please think about them. They can stand up to any examination, brother. The truth always does. The main point you raised, brother, is that you were taught the IM suffix, or Eem, means a plurality of respect. And you've been taught to recite the supporting example of the Eem in Elohim. That sounds almost believable until you dig deeper, brother. First, let's imagine that the claim is true, that Eem is added in Hebrew as a suffix to denote a great respect, a plurality of respect. Well, Omar, if that were the case, don't you think we should see many examples of this? Omar, don't you think we should see this Eem plurality of respect everywhere? Brother, how about we just hope to find one other example? I mean, Omar, I can almost buy that Almighty God is worthy of such respect. Do you think, Omar, that God alone is worthy of such special honor? Well, brother, let's imagine that Eem does mean the highest possible plurality of respect. Should God share this superlative with any man? I want you to think about that, Omar. The claim of Islam is causing God to share the respect due only to him with the man Muhammad. And I should add only Muhammad, brother, because I cannot find a single great man of the Bible referred to with the Eem plurality of respect. Not Adam. I cannot find a single Adamim. Not Abraham. I cannot find a single Abrahamim. Not Moses. I cannot find a single Mosesim or Mosheim. Not Isaiah. I cannot find a single Isaiahim. Not Solomon. I cannot find a single Solomonim. Not Isaac. I cannot find a single Isaacim. Not Yahya. I cannot find a single Yahyaim. Not Jesus. I cannot find a single Jesusim or Yeshuaim. Not even a single Isaim. Not even Ishmael. Not a single Ishmaelim. Which leaves us a puzzling situation, brother. If what you were taught by Islam is true, that Eem in the Hebrew means plurality of respect, it must be so super special that the Hebrews refused to use it, much as they have done with the holy personal name of God, the name they consider too holy to even speak. And that too raises something else for you to think about, Omar. If Islam's claim is true, the only persons given this holy designation are Almighty God, Elo, called Elohim and Yahweh, and a mere man who would not be born for another 2,000 years in a foreign country. Somehow, Islam wants you to believe, brother, that a foreigner is as holy and as respected as Almighty God by the Jewish people. I dare say equal with God in being the only other living soul worthy of the glorifying Eem suffix. And this is a fatal flaw, brother, claiming im means plurality of respect, when it is only used in two cases, Almighty God, Elohim, and a possible, imagined reference to some man in the future who Islam makes Allah's equal. But brother, there is actually a teaching that is completely sound and reliable on the subject matter. The first teaching is that in the Hebrew language, im is actually a suffix of plurality, but only simple plurality, not plurality of respect. Let me give you several examples, brother. Cherub is a single angel. Cherubim is more than one angel. Seraph is a single winged being. Seraphim is more than one seraph. The plural of woman is nashim. The plural of city is irim. The plural of man is anashim. There are several forms of plurality, brother, but I have given you five examples where im means plurality and not plurality of respect. You see, brother, if you have any respect for language, you must respect the Hebrew meaning of Hebrew linguistics. Otherwise, you tell lies to yourself and believe a fantasy. The related teaching being that Elohim is not a plurality of respect, but an actual hint of God's plural nature. This is God's first hint at revealing the Trinity, brother. And it is the Comforter we have written about who has revealed this since Jesus left. The third teaching, Brother Omar, is that the Hebrew word Machmadim is just a Hebrew word meaning altogether lovely or exceptionally lovely. The im suffix is in fact a modifier, but it modifies the adjective lovely to mean more lovely. This is just like the suffix est in the English language you are learning, Omar. You can be great, but if you are called the great est, that is to be the most great. The last thing, brother, is to honestly examine if Muhammad is partner with Allah. Is Muhammad actually worthy for Islam to give him the same respect as you give to Almighty God? Because that partners Muhammad with Allah in respect and glory. If there were any other examples I could find, brother, of prophets praised, nay, worshipped with this suffix, I would think that was possible and maybe plausible usage for plurality of respect given to men. Please look, Omar, search the Hebrew in the Old Testament. Let me know if you can find even one example where the prophets or kings are named with this im plurality of respect. But if you cannot even find one other example, brother, the logic you learned in college should be shouting in your head. The logic demands that you accept the logical conclusion. There is no evidence to support Islam's claim. This claim, by Islam, simply does not make sense. And at that point, brother, you should ask if Islam is telling the truth, or making up a false claim because of their desperation to inject and insert Muhammad into the Bible. Islam is literally changing the Word of God to serve Muhammad's purpose. I know the truth of this matter, Omar, and I have given you clear proof that Islam has told you a falsehood, a lie of convenience. But you have to open your heart and allow yourself to desire the truth, brother. It is impossible that the im suffix means a plurality of respect. If it did, It would be used for every great man of God from Adam to Abraham to Moses to Jesus. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.